Microplastics are tiny fragments of plastic. Nanoplastics are even smaller, and they're invisible to the naked eye. Some of these tiny particles may be produced this size, but often they are fragments of larger pieces of plastic, which, over time, break down and disperse in the environment. These plastic particles vary in composition, quantity, quality, shape and size. Scientists need to standardize how to identify and quantify these particles to generate data on their occurrence in food and on any harmful effects on people, both from the particles themselves and from any chemical or biological contaminants they might absorb. Microplastics and nanoplastics have been found in our environment, our drinking water, and in foods like fish, salt, and honey. We are frequently exposed to them, yet do not have much reliable data. There are gaps in our knowledge that we need to fill with experiments, tests, and data. But first, we must standardize and harmonize our testing and measurement methods. To understand these plastics, scientists need to agree on a roadmap on how to identify, classify, and quantify the particles. Humans are exposed to microplastics and nanoplastics every day, in the air, water, food, and in the environment. We have only limited knowledge about how many microplastic particles are in our food, how many of them we eat, or what happens to them in our bodies. We know even less about nanoplastics. We need to know if they are contaminated by pollutants or microorganisms, and if this contamination modifies their characteristics and effects. To aid this research, we need to use standardized and harmonized methods to identify, quantify, and classify the microplastic and nanoplastic particles we are exposed to in food. This will help us to understand how much of these plastics enter our bodies and the amount entering through food and drinking water. Despite being exposed to microplastics and nanoplastics regularly, scientists are still trying to understand the possible effects on human health. What happens to the particles once they've been ingested? Do they pass through the body or are they absorbed? How does the human body respond to these plastics or the pollutants and microorganisms that are absorbed by them? Scientists must address the data gaps that prevent assessing health effect by conducting more experiments and generating more data.